Sunday the 12th of November is Remembrance Sunday here in the UK. And the website describes Remembrance Sunday as a national opportunity to remember the service and sacrifice of all those that have defended our freedoms and protected our way of life. And there are many hundreds and thousands and millions that have died in that service. And those of us who have benefited from their sacrifice remember them gratefully on Sunday. And for many thousands, that remembrance will be one of great grief as they remember loved ones of theirs who were lost in that service. And for many people, a grief like that is something that they might never get over in their life. Death is so final. We will never again in this life get to meet those who have died. And it's a devastating thing to lose people that we love in any circumstances. However, the Lord Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 5 and verse 4, he taught, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." The Lord Jesus Christ offers comfort to those who mourn. And that statement of the Lord Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 5 is part of a very well-known message from the Lord Jesus Christ. It's taken from the Sermon on the Mount. And the section that I've read from is called the Beatitudes, the blessings of the Lord Jesus Christ. And there are eight blessings that we read of. Perhaps the best known blessing is in verse 5. "Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth." But relevant to Remembrance Sunday, the Lord Jesus Christ taught, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." There is comfort to be found in what the Lord Jesus Christ is offering us. And the Lord Jesus Christ, he is offering that to everybody, but that comfort will not be found by everybody. It tells us in Matthew chapter 5 that the Lord Jesus Christ, there was a multitude of people around him, and he took himself apart from that multitude. And having taken himself apart from the multitude, the Bible teaches that his disciples came to him. And it was only after his disciples separated themselves from the multitude and came specially to the person of the Lord Jesus Christ that he taught these eight Beatitudes. "Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." If you want to benefit from what the Lord Jesus Christ has done, you have to come to him. You have to accept his salvation. You have to come into the good of what he has done for you. And as we remember the sacrifice of those who have given their life to protect our way of life, it's very important that we also remember the Lord Jesus Christ's greater sacrifice. He gave his life on the cross at Calvary as a sacrifice. Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 12 says, "This man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God. For by one offering, he has perfected forever those who are being sanctified." The Lord Jesus Christ can sanctify your life. It can make your life perfect in the eyes of God through what he has done on Calvary. He became the sacrifice for sin. That's what Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 12 says, that he offered one sacrifice for sin. His sufferings on Calvary were acceptable to God for the price of sin. And if you put your trust in him, you can be sanctified. You can be made right with God through faith in the person and in the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. He sacrificed himself on the cross, but he rose again the third day. That's evidence of his victory, that he rose again the third day. And those who believe in him will benefit from his sacrifice. And so if you want to know the comfort of God, those blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. You can know comfort. You can know the assurance of eternal life as your eternal prospect if you put your trust and your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And so as you remember the sacrifice of so many millions in the service of our country, don't forget the sacrifice of the very Son of God himself, who died on the cross in order to pay the price for sin, in order that you can have your sins forgiven. You need to do what the disciples did and come apart and come only to the person of the Lord Jesus Christ and put your trust in him, believe in him, and your sins will be forgiven and you will be saved for all of eternity. May you do so while you have the opportunity.